Hey ladies, jumping on live, Deb's craft, Sunday craft, is with her grandson today, so I decided to pop on and finish some work on this. We're going to work on ephemera today. I hope the lighting's okay. I'm up north, all my lights are on. I don't have my computer either, so bear with me. And I won't be able to see any comments. So this original video, when I made this, I made it July 7th, and it's posted on my Facebook. This is hashtag Christmas in July 2022. It's a collaboration with Sweet Pea Papers. She has some amazing stuff out there. This is a paper design by Sherry Mitchell, and I made this. So I thought today we would make the ephemera I want to go in it using liquid embossing, Dollar Tree glitter glue, and stickles. So let's get started. I'm going to start with this top one. I'm going to leave everything. I'm going to take this off. So what I like about these different mediums is they give it a shine and glitter. So I'm just going to and I like to thin it out a little bit. It doesn't have to be really thick because you still get that shine with it and a little bit of glitter. And then this clear liquid emboss, it's just that. It just gives shine to it. If it'll work today. It's not going to work. This one is Sepa. Oh, that one should work. And it's just gonna put a little bit of shine where you want it. I thought the wording could have a little bit of shine. And this takes 24 to 48 hours to dry. I'd say within 12 hours, it is normally touchable, but I wouldn't package it up for 48. And I'm just following the letters. And then I'm going to put some grain, even though it's a brighter green than what's on this, it'll still pop. The stickles and the glitter glue is really fun to play with. Hold that up to the camera. I love what it does. I'm gonna go set this off to the side. So I mentioned this is also collaboration with Terry from Sweet Pea Papers. There is 20 designers doing what at minimum of one video a week. If you go to my video on my YouTube channel, Chopwood Creations, you'll see the Christmas ephemera holder on there. And below that is a list of everyone. And I'll also below this video when I upload it to YouTube. This is a brown. I'm hoping it's not too bad. This is so, it's so fun, so easy, and it just gives your tags and your pages just a little extra something. I mean, you don't have to do a lot to them. And even if it's a different color than what you're going over, it just gives it a whole different dimension. I've just started playing with these. I forgot my flock at home, which was like a really fine white powder. I would put it over the clear ones, and it makes a snowy effect. It's as simple as that. Simple, fun, and as you can see, I just added a couple pieces of lace to these cards, journaling cards, just to give it a little pop. And even though this is blue I'm going over and I'm using purple stipples, the glitter in it changes. Use the purple one. And if these ever get clogged up, a straight pin, ouch, well, ooh, joys of life, the straight pin will unclog them for you. That was just a little bit more than I wanted on that one, but that's okay. I'll finish these two, and then I'll show you what I'm going to do with the violins I have printed from this kit. And like I said, it's going to be a short video today. And a little bit of green. So we're up north at our cabin. We're getting the driveway put in tomorrow and Tuesday. Really excited about it. Our driveway's been eroded when it rains really bad, and it takes my husband many, many hours to get it drivable again. So we're excited about that. The little things in life, huh? Let's see if this one's open. Oh yeah, this is antique gloss finish. If I wanted to, I could very carefully. Ouch. My arthritis pain is coming back in my thumb, so it's getting really sore. I don't get my next shot until the 16th of August, so I ought to be in lots of pain before then. I was just trying to find something to mix these together. I'm just mixing the glitter with the antique gloss And it's kind of milky. I'm kind of worried now. I've never done that before. We shall see how that one turns out in the end. I'm going to take this one. And I'm going to fill in this blotch. And then this kit, this is called Christmas in Ireland. This kit is by Sherry Mitchell. She no longer has an Etsy shop, but she did fantastic work. So I want to take these violins. No, they're not violins. They're, don't remember the name of them, guys. But I want strings on these, at least a couple. So I'm going to start up here. And try to make a straight line. And then when these are dry, you can wrap a little bit of lace around them or eyelash yarn, anything you want. If you want, you know, do it for a swap. These are so cute. I'm going to do one here too. I'm going to use purple on this one. And it's not real dark, but it gives it a three-dimensional feel. I'm going to use this color on this one. And I finally learned my Cricut. That's what cut all this stuff out. Print and cut. So these are actually a little bit smaller than a kit, because if you have a Cricut, the print and cut is 6.75 by 9.25 inches, so you don't quite get the full size of the 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper, but it saves my hand. So that's those. And then I think I'm going to put a little bit of this, on the cloth too, because when it dries, it'll look like glass. And then a little bit of this pink. Around the side of this watch. And since I have it, oops. As you notice with the Dollar Tree glitter glue, it comes out really fast. There's a big hole. I wish that would have been smaller, but you make do with what you have. And then we'll decorate up the side of this ball and put a little bit on the present. You know, it's wherever you want to highlight. And it just, like I said, it gives it 3D. And it dries beautifully. Adding a little bit, there's like little divots that seem not to have enough, and I can tell. But there is tags like closure and the musical instruments that you can make these into pockets. You can, like I said, you can wrap string around them, and then the cover. It's a little bit dry. I don't know if you can pick that up. Really fun to play with. So ladies, I hope you enjoyed this short little tutorial. Oh my goodness, I can't talk today. On using stickles, liquid embossing, and the art glitter glue from Dollar Tree. And I imagine any art glitter glue would work the same. So with that being said, I'm gonna let you go. Everybody have a great day.